Recovery Roundup, brought to you by OMG Tow Marketing.
Hi, I'm Emily Oz for Tow Industry Week. It's another edition of Recovery Roundup, where we feature towing's power players take on heavy-duty jobs with expertise.
With over 45 million views to his YouTube channel, there are a lot of rock-solid fans of the work of Ron Pratt and his team at Midwest Truck Sales and Service of Scott City, Missouri. On this day, Pratt was called to go fishing to pull this Nissan 350Z from a creek bed without damaging the vehicle. Watch his Century 1150R Rotator on a Peterbilt in action. Here is Pratt with the details.
We get a lot of calls to recover passenger vehicles out of strange situations. This particular one, the customer had called a bunch of different companies and nobody would touch it. This was a Nissan 350Z and he'd missed a curve and went off the roadway. The nose of the car was in the water and the back of the car was stuck on a box culvert. Very little visible damage, and this car was this gentleman's baby. I mean, he didn't want it damaged. Some other towing companies had said that they didn't want to touch it. First of all, it was in an active waterway. It was right underneath some power lines. And they were afraid that they were going to just destroy the undercarriage of the car if they just tied a line to it and started yanking. So the customer called us knowing that we had the capabilities to perform a direct vertical lift. And hopefully the goal was to lift it out without any further damage to the car. We were working with a two-lane road with no shoulder. We had overhead power lines to deal with, so we couldn't have the boom elevated to the same height that we wanted. We ended up assembling the spreader bars and using rim slings and some special chains that I built to go through the rims of the wheels and basically do a four-point lift off of the spreader bars to keep the rim slings and the chains away from the body of the car. Single line lifted the car up and had to make sure everything was rigged just right so that when the car came up it didn't shift one way or the other and damage the undercarriage on the box culvert or start leaking fluids into the active waterway, all while keeping the boom under the power lines without making contact with the power lines.
Just a little at a time. So I gotta keep the boom pretty well flat until I get past those power lines. All right, you got her? I'm gonna start swinging. Actually, I'm gonna bring it back, roll the carriage back, get it back past this stuff.
It was a successful job, very successful job. The owner was quite happy. He was very distraught over his car, though. I mean, that thing was really his baby. So, but he was pleased with the outcome. We did a wonderful job, and that was, bottom line, customer was happy. There was no damage to the environment. Nobody got hurt. Everybody went home. It was at the end of a good day.
That ought to be more than enough, don't you think?
We'll be featuring more of Pratt's recovery work here on ATTV in the future. And if you would like to submit your recovery to be featured on the Roundup, please visit recoveryroundup.com. Thanks for watching.